18 psychological tricks that can help you get what you need. Do you wish you knew the simple psychological tricks that would increase your chances of getting that job, winning someone's trust, or even getting your child to eat vegetables? We at Boomsley are confident that using these psychological tricks correctly will allow you to achieve everything you need out of life. Just memorize these simple tips. Number 1, if your child won't eat vegetables, try letting them choose. Let's say you want them to eat their broccoli. Give them the choice between broccoli or carrots. The child will choose the lesser evil, or actually end up enjoying both. Number 2, if you want to give a person a piece of advice that they will take seriously, make sure you have someone trustworthy on your side. Tell them that your grandmother or father gave you a similar piece of advice. People trust parents on a subconscious level, and this endorsement will make your words seem more powerful. Number 3, if you want to ask a person for something, try to find a moment when this person is tired. For example, if you want to ask your boss for a day off, you should try doing it at the end of the day. A person who wants to deal with these questions faster is more likely to give you what you need. Number 4, body and mind are connected. If you need to become angry, try frowning or clench your teeth and focus on something for 10 seconds. Quickly, you will feel that you are actually angry. Number 5, before a job interview, pay a lot of attention to your appearance. It is scientifically proven that people who are more physically attractive are believed to be more intelligent. Number 6, if you have an annoying song stuck in your head, try to remember the last lines of the song. People forget finished tasks much faster than unfinished ones. Number 7, in order to get a person to like you, especially during an argument, say these phrases in your mind during a conversation: I value your opinion even if I disagree with you, and I like you. Number 8, phrases like, I think, or if you want make you look like an insecure person. So it's best if you don't use them in a conversation or in an argument. Number 9, an extreme date is the best start to a romantic story. If you are going on a date and want your partner to like you, you should choose a place that will make them feel a rush of adrenaline. For example, a roller coaster, an escape room, or a horror movie. Number 10, if you need to understand something difficult, try to explain it to someone else. During the explanation, you are more likely to realize something you did not understand before. Number 11, even if you know what someone is talking to you about, don't interrupt them with the phrase "I know that," listen to the whole story. This will help you make a good impression, and this person is more likely to like you. Number 12, everyone knows that in order to get something big, you need to start small. For example, if you want to ask a friend for a big favor, you should ask them for a small one first. But this trick also works the other way around. If you want to ask someone to lend you money and you need $50, ask for $200. The person is very likely to refuse to give you the larger amount of money, but they will feel uncomfortable and will give you the amount you actually need. Number 13, if you don't want to do a boring job, you should pretend that you are doing something incredibly interesting, and that way you're more likely to find someone to do it for you. Number 14, mirroring is a great trick, but do not overuse it. The ability to mimic another person's actions establishes a sense of emotional connection. Try to do it so that other people don't notice it. Number 15, if you did someone a favor and they're grateful, don't say "no problem," say something like, "Of course, friends are supposed to help each other." In the future, if you ask this person for a favor, they are more likely to help you. Number 16, use nouns instead of verbs when speaking. Research has proven that using nouns increases your chances of convincing a person of something. For example, instead of saying, "Do you want to save several animals?" you should say, "Do you want to become the savior of several animals?" Number 17, if you have trouble remembering names when meeting someone, say their name. For example, "Nice to meet you, Jack." This way you will memorize their name faster and better. Number 18, shaking hands means so much in nonverbal communication that we should not underestimate it. There are 3 basic hand positions in a handshake. If you place your hand over someone else's, you demonstrate dominance. If your hand is under the other person's hand, you show submission. So, in order to feel comfortable and make the other person feel the same way, make sure your hands stay in an equally vertical position during the handshake. Let us know in the comments if you will be using any of these tricks.